Blog Talk Radio. receiving God, the all-seeing God. Direct my path now, right now. Lord, if I mess up, will you fix me from now until eternity? Will you direct me if I
encyclopedia of free. Oh, you a Leo.
I heard that rather unique.
You such a diva.
It's such a pleasure to meet.
Someone of your sex and one in a million. Nothing else matters.
Cause I love to turn you on. You're like my favorite song.
Do you really want to be seen? Do you really want to be heard? Bootcamp Enterprises can get you seen and heard. Contact us today at 818-277-2021 or email us, shane@bootcampenterprises.com.
Once in a lifetime, the Victor Clark Collection. You will feel empowered. Wearing the Victor Clark Collection. The best things in life comes in the Victor Clark Collection. Order online today. www.victorclarkstore.com. The Victor Clark Collection. The number one clothing brand in the country. The number one clothing brand in the world. Everybody loves Victor Clark.
Hey, hey, I'm Curtis Blow, the legendary rapper and pastor, and I support WDC on SCT, and that's What's the Count on Sickle Cell Trait Awareness. Now, it's not just sickle cell anemia that can cause complications, but the sickle cell trait can cause sudden death if the body overheats from physical exertion or high levels of stress. So it's not too late to get tested for the sickle cell trait and learn more about the silent killer. It's not just in African Americans, y'all. So follow the WDC on Twitter at WDCONSCT. That's Twitter at WDCONSCT.
We want to thank everybody for tuning in tonight to the Q Media Nation show. You know, it always gets live on Friday night. I'm here, Sister Falana in the studio. Of course, I got a couple of people that I want to shout out, folks on the line. We're going to make that line available to them to do that. And, of course, you know, you were Jennifer Hudson opened us up tonight. And we got quite a few artists that we weren't able to play in the beginning of the week. So we will get that out to you all today because there are a lot of artists are making sure that they put their music out there. And we're responsible for playing it because, you know, we love the independent community. We love the independent nation. 347-426-3974. I want to welcome one of my buddies. I can say that. I can really say that because he's been really on the mark when I say that his artist, Precise, has been one of the most consistent members on the team. I want to thank him and thank him. Give you a shout out.
My name is Videl J for Hip Hop Recording Science Banter, and I want to give a smash out to all the artists, independent artists that's working within this network, that's going for their dreams. Keep doing what you're doing, and you will succeed. You will
That's right. Exactly. We're going to have Precise on around the time that he's dropping quite a few things he was trying to tell me about. So we're going to make sure that we make that available. And if you go to our blog, which is qmedianation.blogspot.com, you can get a look at who Precise really is. He's one of those artists that has just come in and made Q Media Nation his own Haitian-born rapper, and is very, very tied to Haiti, and especially during the time of the crisis there. He was one of the foremost writers that kept giving us the information, the news, the views from the people, not just what you saw on TV, but actually heart-to-heart conversations. So thank you to your whole camp, concise, and we love you.
Oh, okay. Thank you, sister. No problem.
All
I'll
right.
Keep you posted.
All right. Thank you. Now, for those who may have just been joining us, you know, all week, we have been having some bang up folks coming through. They might just be stopping through for a moment, but they've been showing a lot of love to Q Media Nation. So we want you to show your love, 347-426-3974. If you want to send us your music submissions, qmediagroupusa@gmail.com. We got a real, real hot cut that came in from Nels, my boy from Bare Knuckle Beats. You know, that's a company that I'm involved with. He keeps saying I'm the boss, but he's doing more work than I am with it. So shout out to Bare Knuckle Beats. We're going to be having a lot of music come in from them, a lot of beats for sale. Later in the program, we will have Big Fez, who is one of the hottest producers. Once you see the list of people that he has worked with and those he's going to work with, you will see why he came to the Q Media Nation family. Shout out to my 501 crew who's on the line with us. I appreciate you each and every time you call in. So thank you, thank you, thank you. One love. Here is Reason to Look by Main Scrap, my boy out of the Bronx.
I'm throwing off that piss for that cuss. Give him reason to look. I'm strapped, I'm nifty, I'm mad. Can't you hate a little homie, cut scrap. Give him reason to look. You can pop, you can bang, do your thing. No change, little homie, just remember. Give him reason to look. If you hustle, you can flip. Who you with? If you flip, little mama rocket. And give him reason to look. I see you looking up, so I'm showing no home. I'm so fly, get dressed at the airport on. There's no competing, looks could be deceiving. Everywhere I go, they stare, so I give them reasons. Air Force check, red monkeys check, white tee check, stacks on deck. If you don't get right, nigga, you get left. Do it like this, I told you, boy, I showed you, boy. Got bitches yelling, since I'm a soldier, boy. These niggas drilling, cause they know they bitches love the kid. They know I'm from the act, they love my swag, you did. I ain't a millionaire, but I do it big. I got a grand hustle, bitch, you know what. No changing me, you just do you, my nigga, I'ma do me. I know you mad that guap is on me, like your pocket pop a pill, cause them shits is on me.
Reason to look, I'm fly, I'm high, I push, I'm throwing off that piss for that cush.
Give me reason to look, I'm strapped, I'm nifty, I'm mad, can't hate a little homie, cut scrap.
Give me reason to look, you can pop, you can bang, do your thing, no change, little homie, just remember.
Give me reason to look.
It's a new edition, can you stand the rain? I'm higher than LeBron James, when you give that boy some lane. Smoking on that purple rain, I love weed, I think I'm about to marry Jane. You let your bitch see me, now she wanna marry me. I ain't tripping, get your look on. I know you wouldn't be looking if I was looking wrong. I don't know what they be on, but I don't grill niggas when I got shades on. Head on a champion, it's like I'm in the union, cause I stay with construction. Antiques, and I don't care if they drag it, they just give me a ticket.
I'm getting real stacked.
I'm fly, I'm high, I push, I'm throwing off that piss for that cush.
Give me reason to look.
I'm strapped, I'm nifty, I'm mad, can't hate a little homie, cut scrap.
Give me reason to look.
You can pop, you can bang, do your thing, no change, little homie, just remember.
Give me reason to look.
So you can flip who you with. If you flip, little mama rocket.
And give them reason to look.
Give them reason to look. Give them reason to look.
another man down. Yeah,
think it's sweet. I send your ass to freak around.
Another man down. Yeah.
You know the tale.
Another man down.
Yeah. Around.
Another man down. Yeah.
You know the tale.
Another man down.
Another man dead. Now they're gonna stop him. Y'all gonna have to pop him. We good God gangle. We MOP mop him. Whoever got a problem, suing your medulla oblongata from top to bottom. Fizzy, what we provide him? A shot to the head, a hospital bed. You said that you blind, so that's what y'all said. You wanna be crisp, and here's a shot to your leg. They gonna lift your punk ass up out of here, bread. They call me Sly, I'm not the legal type of fella. I'm from New York, I play with more hawks than Mike Fratella. My H-Town. Getting it, I could tell you. They riding around, they putting their hands on that mozzarella. Fella, I'm like the rap Lou Piniella. The rhyming and the timing just never quite glued together. I try to save the hood, but you can ask whatever. Y'all wanna get on some feet? My pleasure.
Yo, I let the fifth speak. Turn this shit and miss me. Correct. Another man down.
Yeah. Jeez, think it's sweet. I send your ass up. Sweet. Correct.
Another man down.
You know the tale.
Another man down. Another man
dead. You know the same. Another man dead. Another man dead. We don't f*** with that hip hop, this bubble gum. The slums I'm from, they all troublesome. They say they wanna get at me, but they don't wanna come to the jungle where the lions and bears are vying for theirs. It's hard to get out, we've been trying for years. I ain't prepared to die in the tear. But if I have to, I have to. It's factual, I am aware. Better recognize who I am. I'm telling you, I'm a shooter than a shooter. You ain't a shotter or a rider, just a Tupac fan. Real gangster is something that you not, man. I've been doing this since 9-1. Rappers say that I'm front and sign one. And I'ma show him my rap sheet as long as it's rap book. Give him that look and he's done.
Yo, I let the fifth speak. Turn this shit and miss me. Correct. Another man down.
Yeah. He's thinking sweet. I send your ass up. Sweet. Correct.
Another man down.
Yeah. You know the tale.
Another man down.
Yeah. Correct.
Another man down.
Yeah. You know the tale.
Another man down.
Yeah. Correct.
Another man down.
Be loved. back door, fear none, got it on my tack. I done been a lot of places, probably with a never been. Got them in the hood, now the lanes out the element. Talking to them like I'm already mega big. Take her to the telly, see if she know how to take a. The streets created a beast, unstoppable. Minds are slow, that's colder than a popsicle.
Upon you, as I relax amongst the stars and nothing new, yeah. Waiting on my time to attack and destroy, heading to the vicinity, attack and destroy, I've got a person of a delicacy sweetly, and I'ma show you what the insolence will bring, walking around here looking half crazy, your pants tight, they shouting what you're saying, cause I was raised for a tough, unstoppable, never scared, real to real, unstoppable, that's why I live in my own world, got a heart for the ladies, got a lot of girls, monster character, sort of unstable. Physical, nuclear, ground zero, unstable. I'm on the ground like a giant, so unstoppable. Pound around and fire.
We gotta do better.
2012, gotta do better.
The world.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the motto.
Montana.
NYC.
La Música de Harry Fry.
Man, this beat too hard. I ain't even gon' play with it. Beat the f*** up. I ain't even gon' play with it. Louis V. Low D and G on the sofa. $100 bills on the table like they coasters. You know how to find me. Catch me in the mall. Stack Fifth Ave, set this stuff off the wall. See my jeans is a designer. You know when I'm behind her. One thing about my shooters, yeah, they gon' find you. Big face, Rolly, motherfucker, I'm a shiner. Never been broke, motherfucker, I'm a grinder. So good, you gotta put it in the grinder. 233 the first week, I'ma remind you.
Backstage at the stage at the corner. Hair like Rihanna. True game was awesome. Tell by all if she want a shot call. Wanna be with a baller. Shot call. I can tell by all if she want a shot call. Wanna be with a baller. Shot call. I can tell by all if she want a shot call.
Back on the scene. Crispy and clean. LV logo. Even on the chain. Don't be funny style with the funky, funky cow. I do a fresh style. I let the money pass. She don't wanna talk till she seen the top out. Call me Pimp Homicide. Let her jump out. Feel the texture. Rumble on weapon. Stand on my own, not who I stand next to. Can I hit it in the morning? Michelle, I be pimping like a pound on the dash. Now when the money hit the floor, better pick it up.
Bring you up.
I can be a sponsor. Not the backstage at the stage at the concert. Hair like Rihanna. Shoot game was awesome. Tell by all if she want a shot call. Wanna be with a baller. Shot call. I can tell by all if she want a shot call. Wanna be with a baller. Shot call. I can tell by all if she want a shot call. Shorty got potential. I can be a sponsor. Not the backstage at the stage at the concert. Hair like Rihanna. Shoot game was awesome. Tell by all. She wanna shot call, wanna be with a baller. Shot call, I can tell by all if she wanna shot call. Wanna be with a baller. Shot call, I can tell by all if she wanna shot call.
Hey, say G,
yeah.
Let's get this back one time.
Sit for my n****s on the block, dodge it one time.
Hey.
Run it hard, run it up at least one night.
That's right.
Put your middle fingers in the air one time.
Yeah.
Ride with me, fuck the city.
Red rubber bands on my bankroll.
gon' get the ladder. So fly, so bad, you got a clever ass. We living at your fantasy, suckers can't handle this. They know we run the city, shout it, it's unanimous. Shout it out, so, so, 944K. For the hand, whole thing, nigga, like the old days.
Hey,
dope boy, trap, trap, swag. 100-carat chain, quarter meal in the bag. I'm no longer poppin' tags, I just let them hang. Something doing bad, I just do my thing. And I ain't front straight by the boot, G-code, bad. Flat on the back, booty, G-though. 20 grand in my pants, 50 in my G-code. Jesus, checkin' with me, and we checkin' up the city. Hey, yo,
sit for my n****s on the block, that's a one time. Runnin' hard, runnin' up at least one night. Put your middle fingers in the air one time. Ride with me, up the city up one time. Up the city up, up the city up, up the city up, city up one time. Up the city up, up the city up, up the city up, city up one time. I seen Dizzle in traffic with a top off. So much Louis in looking like a knockoff. Violation that'll get your ass knocked up. Get your hot stuff. Ever see me in the club with my shades off? It was a cool contest, I guess the shades lost. 28-5, yeah, that's my cost. My closet's so big, I swear I got lost. What? Yeah, I think I'm gon' need a map. We throw them birdies in the pool, make them swim a lap. Rip it kinda clockwise, that's a backstroke. My chain so big, look like my back broke. Yeah, we bout to open the city up, go broke. I'm ballin' so hard, I need the whole coast. Six spots in one night, they call that club hopping. That new tip and dizzle got the club rockin'. It's one on the block, that's a one time. Run it hard, run it up at least one night. Put your middle fingers in the air one time. Ride with me, up the city up one time. Up the city up, city up, city up, city up, city up, city up one time. Up the city up,
okay.
Up the city up,
all
right. Up the city up, city up one time.
I'm talking 8 town. Lean pound brick, chop up in the round clip. Keep it with me, out still. Anyone around still. Bout that drama, boy, I promise. Got a old presidential, doesn't blow it, that Obama.
Yeah, I'm talking plenty, chop of scopes on the AR. You know how I do it, 40 autos on the car. When I came up out the womb, all I wanna be a star. What the fans don't stop me, life sentence in the car.
And when we fit, we reminiscing about when we was in the kitchen. Okay. Representing, playing, playing, need to play. Attention, put it on for the city free. This ACL, do it for Big Meech. You feel me?
Got all that blood strong, hey. Straight for the week. Order $5,000, put it all on the street. Order 25 bricks, I put them all in the street. Hey, stay down, turned up, while you sleep. What's up? On the block, that's the one time. Ride it hard, ride it up at least one night. Put your middle fingers in the air one time. Ride with me, up the city up one time. Up the city up, city up, city up, city up, city up, city up one time. Up the city up, city up, city up, city up, city up, city up one time.
Hey,
who do we have on the line with us right now?
Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy, Mr. Nigga Rude Doobie for Life Entertainment Media, A&R / you know, main marketing promotion and genius. You already know.
That's right, that's right. And in the background is one of the artists from their camp, Busy, who will be with us in a couple of weeks. We love you, we love you, we love you. Life Entertainment Media, who has been hitting us up all over the airwaves, whether it's internet, whether it's text messaging, whatever. This group, this whole camp is all that. So thank you for calling in, and we're looking forward to a lot of your camp being with us in the next few weeks.
Yeah, definitely, definitely, man. You know I got to call and show support. You know, I mean, Q is the, yo, Q, she gets it in, man. She give you the exclusives, you know what I mean, good interviews and all that. You know what I mean, I got my hat tips to you. You're definitely good, phenomenal female that I always would love to keep in contact with. and always would love to be on your show anytime. You know, I'll bring you the hot artist, trust me.
That's
going
right.
Down. We got a treat soon too on the 28th. We're gonna let them know. We ain't gonna let the kid out the bag, but we gonna get to that though.
Exactly. And for all of you who don't know, this is one of the international connections that you all need to connect with. We're an independent artist. He definitely has the stages that are wide open for you, as well as that international stage, which is in Australia. So shout out to my Australia people. We already been functioning out there, but you know what? The more the merrier, the make it better.
Definitely, mm-hmm. Man. And everybody go out and go pick up that number one single, you know what I mean? Want to know you from Busy, man. It's crazy. Go pick it up on iTunes, Amazon. Most downloaded, you know what I mean, for the past month. It's crazy.
That's right. It's coming up next, so stay tuned. That cut that he's talking about, we're about to spin it in a couple of minutes. So stay locked in. This is QMedia Nation on Block Talk Radio. 347-426-3974. I'm Q. You know it. This is Kalana, a.k.a. Q. You know it don't get no better than this. The fam is the fam. Peace.
Yeah.
Everybody wanna have a taste of that good life. Fancy lifestyle, live a millionaire dream. Shop a Swiss man's cause come at a good price. It's all for the living a millionaire. Yeah.
Dreams of smashing the baddest ball. No limits to nothing, it's yours, you can have it all. Talking, she skim before she brush her teeth. She bought monopolies and she take it all. Never ask questions, she just want hers. Do what you tell her, never ever work my last nerve. She play her position, she know how to play the ball. She know about some other O's, so I call her Amber Rose. Super head banger, that's what I'm into. She don't need long hair, it's all in the mental. She got a strong mind, smart mouth too. She get a Nike, I'll never say what she bout to. She got it with the taste, because she just make her. I tell her better, love me good, cause another word. She say that's some big shoes to fill, and I'm doing fine. Nobody polish like I polish fiction. Taste of that good life, fancy lifestyle, live a millionaire dream. Shop a Swiss man's come at a good price. It's all a part of living a millionaire, she was all alone, she stared at me and grinned, and it was hard for me to pretend she ain't exist. this though. Been around beautiful women, but I ain't been this close. I walk mean, you should have thought a twist though. Jumping side to side like shorty was a 6'4". No makeup, shoulders all natural. I'm trying to build up the courage so I can ask her out. And knowing me, I can't take rejection. I can't play dumb until I learn my lesson. No player card, no lines for my best friend. Don't go out of bounds and stay in line with my questions. She got me wanting her better than yesterday. Tomorrow's not promised and today is like yesterday. I want to talk to you with love and take your breath away. I'm talking every last breath until there's nothing left to say.
I really want to know you. They got some things I want to show you. Let's be high off the love. I really want to know you. They got some things I want to show you. Let's be high off the love. I really want to see if you have what it takes to make all my dreams come true. All I need is you to give me a chance so we can fly away, away, yeah. Whoa. I really wanna know you. They got some things I wanna show you. Let's be high off the love. I really wanna know you. They got some things I wanna show you.
Seeing paid for those groups. She's in a 4-inch mood, referring to the shoes. Jimmy Choo's, where she getting cool. Cooks in a walk, magnificent catwalk. Keys, call her fist. Diamonds where it's pierced. Tap behind her lower ear, as well the lower back. Little black dress, compliment where it's fat. Excuse me, curse, poke out the chairs. Mud face, curlers in the hair. Before the pumps, in the clubs. Occasional blood, please don't judge. Humble in person, Louis V bag. Coach person, writes her own checks. Starts delicate curses. Girlfriend, you working, compliment to the boss. My goal works perfect.
Perfect. Word up.
Love, the way you put that.
check, check. Blowing haze out the check. DJ Chris Young.
Yeah. Yo, Chris Young, you ready? Okay, I never had shit, including the fly whip. Cop me a chain, including the fly whip. Moving through the city in some continental shit. Put diamonds in the wrist, you can see it through the skin. I be cooling, I admit, like I'm coming through the vent. Spell a wild sale shit, check my clientele lit. Hop up out the Phantom with some chicken named Diana. Born and raised about Atlanta, let me hear the on camera. What? That's another note. Rose gold, rodeo, stack cheese, provolone, fly new, carry on high. Really good in this shit, boy, that's me. You other boys just puff like Gretzky. Tell a way to bring the bottles like Pronto. And I'll be ballin' till the morning like Alonzo. Mi amo, meet me at the condo. Thinking what I'm thinking, for combo.
On the sink, bruh. Laprilla top, guess she a fashionista. We smoke in the pizza. Learned that from a prince in the pizza. Big money on the Panerai. Now I'm just on the jet till your time flies. I still love me a hood chick. What's not smoking is always understood, Chris.
Know ya, think ask you places I can show ya. All the things you've ever seen in your dreams. Oh. Let me know what the deal. We can roll, we can chill. By the by, if you're tired, we can vibe all night. All right. I said you're mine. You tell me yours. If we get bored, you lock the door.
Like to show you, taking trips out to Barcelona, Paris, Venice, have romantic dinners, keep room for dessert when the food is finished, I'ma break you off, like the hoops and music, pick it with chicks that I choose to move with, so if you would tell me who you prove it, I tell you who you are, and figure out if whether you just with me for the call, but it ain't what a man drives, it's what drives a man, and if a man dies, for the things he believes in, if so, when he dies, it'll sting that he's leaving. Just ride, even through the darkest weather. Get rich, stack it up, cheddar. Keep the blunt lit, give me respect. I bet we'll be happy together. One.
Let me know what the deal. We can roll, we can chill. By the by, if you're tired, we can vibe all night.
Shout out to everyone who's been with us, riding the Q Media Nation Trail here tonight. It's Friday. You know how we always do Friday night. We always try to give you more music than coffee. We appreciate you all logging on tonight. And if you're calling in, we thank you just the same. If you are intending on calling in, you can do so at 347-426-3974. We have some really cool people from the independent industry. We have Chicago, New York. We have Sydney, Melbourne. We've got places that people don't even know that we're in. And we're already there. So if you're an independent artist and you really want to get your music out there, you're really looking for an outlet, by all means, stop by the Q Media Nation. Of course, our Facebook group, you can always connect with independent artists in there. And we will be joined later in the program with Big Fez, who, I mean, has been one of the top people, one of the top producers in the industry. So it's somebody you all will need to get acquainted with. So shout out to him, shout out to his camp, shout out to everyone who has been able to connect with us. If you would like to do so and you want to either call in or write into the show, if we're off the air, you can always connect with us, 201-203-1983. That's the office line. And if you want to send in a video submission, you can do so at theindieartistmovement@gmail.com. Once again, theindieartistmovement@gmail.com. You know, of course, we are your source for independent thought, politics, money, music, and life. And as always, on Twitter at Indie Talk Japan, we always get a lot of funny tweets. Shout out to Boot Camp for retweeting, reposting. Always showing the love on a continuous basis. You know, we have to have a million hats with Q Media Nation, as well as enough arms and legs to reach out to everyone to make the event. So shout out to my crew that's out there in California making many, many strides for us at Q Media. When we started this venture a few years ago, we were thinking, oh, we're just going to produce a little show once a week. We did that for a little while, and we kept seeing where people kept calling us and asking us, well, why don't you all be on more than one night a week? So we changed that night and went to another night during the week where we thought we would have more of an audience, and they just kept asking for more and more and more. So we turned it into a 5-night a week. So we're on every weeknight live. We normally take off probably like the third week of every month so that we can catch up with some folks and reach out to others, making sure that we connect in the right way. So we've got a lot of new artists, a lot of new guests, a lot of new music. You know, we heard from Busy, who's out of New York, his camp, Life Entertainment Media, the whole camp is just, I mean, they have energy to burn. So shout out to them. I even had an interesting conversation about an hour before the show from an actor who's going to be joining us. He connected with my partner, Nell, who you know has been a major supporter of the show from day one. And he and Nell have a new single. It's called Smack. So we'll be debuting it more than likely next week so that you can have an opportunity to hear it. But you've been hearing though on another cut that we have in the studio. And it was the Super Bowl cut, you know, from last weekend when they won. We debuted it on Monday. So shout out to Nels and all his crew for putting that together. Because these songs they've been producing, he and Lexa Drew, they did Just Do It. It's phenomenal. I'm going to play it just prior to the interview. But just to give you a little bit of a background, a lot of actors, actresses, you know, we were connecting with Hinton Battle, who was in Dreamgirls. Of course, you know, Tracy, who is the acting coach to the stars. You know, she was acting coach for Busta Rhymes and Eve, especially Eve when she had her own show, and for Busta Rhymes, a lot of other folks. She actually did the movie Just Another Girl on the IRT. So it was an independent film. You know, our connection down in Houston has been phenomenal. A lot of independent movies coming out of there. If you want to check out some of the trailers from those movies, you can do so on our blog, which is qmedianation.blogspot.com. So shout out to everyone who has been sending us their information as well as coming on and being guests. Because we get to know you more on an intimate basis and really develop the resources that people, when they listen in and they don't know where to take their career, they really can have some real, real connections to future. So shout out to everyone who's with us on a Friday night. We're waiting for Big Fez to call in. And as soon as he does, we will play a couple of cuts and get ready for him to be with us. And you can call in 347-426-3974 if you have any questions for him. If not, we're just going to breeze right through the interview and just play his music, let you know what kind of producer he is. And it, from children to adults, he's doing his thing.
We don't have to say about it, no, we don't know it all. How we doing now, you already know, already know. And we live in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, here we go now.
season. Science, it's all chemistry. G-Men deserves it. Super Bowl next on the checklist, they earned it. 9-7 postseason undefeated. And when the Indianapolis caps off the season, all the hard work on the field for a reason. When the spotlight got the losing teams leaving, through all the injuries, mishaps, even the losses, the focus of a team channel through Sam Crawford. Turn around awesome, drive determination, desire, no explanation how the Giants elevated. And after coin toss, call it heads and tails. It doesn't matter when you focus, it ain't hard to tell. New York, New York, it's the city of dreams. Giants bringing home the trophy and the Super Bowl ring.
One. Alive God. Muhammad is the messenger of God. You know what I'm talking about? This is something real, right? Yeah. Now I'm not ready for this. I'm going to tell y'all one. Alive God. Muhammad is the messenger of God. You know what I'm talking about? This is something real right here. If you're not ready to listen, I need you to cut it out. But if you cut it out, you might not learn nothing from it. This your girl, Miss Toy. Yeah, I love y'all. Come on, let's do it.
Yeah, know how to block them now. You better read about her. You better look me up. Facebook or being about her. Know how to shut you down, cause I'm a clown with ya. Know how to be a leader, cause I'm a down sister. Ain't gotta eat you up, that's not my appetite. But I can feed you up and make you feel like I got you mystified, cause I'm so dynamic. And they keep playing that song and you gon' vibe with it. I'm just gon' stay up on them, I make them feel good. Let them know that it's that girl up out of Inglewood. She with the peacemaker, a heat maker, laser. I got longevity, so you can never erase her. I got them throwing up, they want to be whispering. But why you shucking and jiving, Miss Toy is listening. Ain't gotta roll you up, I'ma let you fold me up. Hit after hit after hit, so go on and blow me up.
Make them compensate, say the bull pay to play.
once in a lifetime. The Victor Clark Collection. You will feel empowered wearing the Victor Clark Collection. The best things in life comes in the Victor Clark Collection. Order online today. www.victorclarkstore.com. The Victor Clark Collection. The number one clothing brand in the country. The number one clothing brand in the world. Everybody loves Victor Clark.
Shout out to all my Q Media Nation family. We have just been joined by the man himself, Fascination. We love him here, songwriter, entrepreneur. He is just one of the hottest people that we've had on with us. I'm just getting to know his work, but some of you out there already know who he is. We've been playing one of his cuts that has been consistently on our playlist, and there was couple of nights that folks in the international community asked for us to play that song again. And originally we thought it was in an R&B cut, and it actually was a gospel song. So shout out to Reverend Tina, because it really resonates with a lot of folks. And to know that we have her producer here with us on the line, we really appreciate it. Fascination, how are you tonight?
I'm doing absolutely fabulous. And how about you?
I'm all right. Now, we're definitely going to run into a lot of stuff through your interview, because I'm telling you, look at the website, it's like, what? You know, most websites is just, you know, a little flash here and some other stuff. But yours is really, really detailed. So it's like taking a trip, and you don't get on your website and get right off. You're on. And you're clicking through a couple of things sometimes, through a couple of things all through it. So I love your website. I really do. And I want to thank Shane for connecting us, because we've been able to see a lot of work come from the independent nation. But at the same time, to have someone who's a producer like yourself, who has worked with a lot of artists, we are appreciative of you coming to the show.
It's absolutely my pleasure. And I just want to thank you and Shane for even having me on the show, you know, because I'm very talented, but very, very, very humble as well. And I definitely want to throw a great shout out to Shane at Bootcamp Enterprises. And, you know, I've been working with him for a few years now, and we've always had a great relationship. And so, you know, things, and as the future moves forward, you know, big things and greater things are going to happen. And he just hooked me up with Jay Magic out of South Africa, and so we're going to work pretty soon as well.
We had Jay on Monday night, and he was phenomenal. Jay just let us know, you know, to connect with the U.S. market is tremendous, because there are a lot of international artists who don't know how to connect to the U.S. market, though a lot of U.S. artists connect to the international market, you know, in a pretty sound way. So shout out to you for bringing that international flavor into the United States as well.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. So I'm pretty sure that when me and him actually get in the lab and put something together, I'm sure it's going to be a heater.
Okay. Now, how long have you been in the industry?
I'd like to say pretty much all my life, because I've always been in it in one capacity or another, you know, it's kind of evolved into where I'm at now. And, you know, I kind of began my journey as a choreographer.
Oh, okay.
And, and through my gift and ability of dance and choreography, I was able to travel the world. Pretty much. And most of it was in the oriental side of, like, Japan. I did Tokyo, Yokohama, Kobe, Kyoto, Nagoya, Osaka, Singapore, Malaysia.
we were in the same stomping ground. I was in Shizuoka. That's where we started the show, actually.
Oh, really?
This show actually started in Japan, and I brought it over here. So that's where both of my audiences is from. So they request a lot of the music, because they don't speak English, of course. So dance and music is big there.
Okay, all right. Yeah, because I lived there 6 months right after my first trip there. I stayed 6 months straight.
Okay.
And I did like 5 trips after that one, you know. So, and, you know, and that's kind of how I got started on that aspect of it. And then I did some choreography for a band that got signed to a major deal and started touring with them, and that brought me around the music business. And I just saw something else that I was inspired to do, and then when I did it and put my hands on it, it just kind of came natural. Just the beat of the drum was already inside my soul, so it just came out with the beats, too.
Now, with you going out into the Japanese market and really discovering another side of things, when you went internationally, did you find that there was more of an appreciation for music there, music and just entertainment in general, more so than here, where sometimes we take things for granted in the U.S.?
Yeah, well, the thing about it was they appreciated my talent, like, way more than here. You know, like, when I was over there, they treated me like I was, a superstar. I mean, it was amazing, the treatment and, you know, the things that they did for you. I mean, it was an amazing experience. They really cherish your talent and respect you to the highest. And it's definitely not like that here. You got to work real hard to get some respect down here in the States. You know?
Right.
You got to be putting it down.
Mm-hmm. I remember I always tell people this story. The first time I ever went to a Japanese club and I stepped on somebody's foot, you know, here you got to hit the deck. Over there, they were moving out of the way like, I'm sorry it was there for you to step upon. But it really is a good place that if there are independent artists that are out there to take what you know and go overseas and be appreciated and come back and share that love with other artists, which is why we created it, to create an avenue for artists who were finding such difficulty in getting out into the international audience and having some kind of media promote them. We started the show and just making sure that people get out there. Now, you said choreography, I know songwriting, you know, producing. Which is your favorite?
Ooh. Well, I guess I don't know if I really actually have a favorite, and I guess they were all favorites when I did them, started out doing them, because it all happened step by step. You know, I wasn't doing them at the same time, so, you know, of course, choreography was it when I was doing it, and then I evolved into music, I evolved into, you know, writing and arranging and producing. Now I'm into videography, I'm editing videos and shooting commercials. Yeah, you know, so, I mean, it's just kind of all, at the end of the day, you know, it's like, as I'm steady adding more skills to my repertoire, all of it kind of enhances the other, you know, and not knowing that it was going to be needed, saying, even before I still got into the music, at one point I wanted to be known as a great poet writer, and I used to write poetry all the time.
Okay.
And so at that point, you know, like I was just, I mean, I could really, really write and put words together and make them rhyme and all that. You know, that's before I even got into the, knew I was going to do music. And finally, when I did go to the music side, I mean, then that skill came into play when I'm getting ready to write songs now. So I already knew how to put the words together.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Now, do you think that, and this is a very personal question, because I always talk about this, how there's so few arrangers in the industry as there are. Everybody can say, I'm a producer, I'll put some beats together, I'll put this and that together. But to really make your music stand out, do you think that we're at a loss right now in the industry overall for good arrangements?
Yeah, I mean, it really is. I mean, because, yeah, I mean, I guess I would say there are very few people like myself, you know, that actually understand what the word producer means, because just because you made the beat doesn't make you a producer. I mean, it's the guy standing in the room and orchestrate and control everything. I mean, everything that's going on from the music standpoint, from the keys, the bass, the strings, the guitars, listening to the vocal arrangements, making sure that they're riding the track right, that the lyrics even make sense, that when they're singing the hook, or then they get to the verse, does it even still make sense? You know, I mean, there's so many elements to it, you know. And when you're working with a singer that can sing so great, I mean, their vocals are so big that you, as a producer, you have to know how to harness that talent to make a record, because they'll sing all over the place.
Right.
You know, and you have to know how to control all that stuff, you know, in the studio to make a record.
Mm-hmm.
And that just comes from years of experience just over and over and over and over and over, you know.
That's interesting that you say that, because a lot of folks will come in the industry thinking, you know, I can sing, I can just sing. And they might not necessarily come from a church background where you actually have to sing with other people to know where your range, your pitch, and all of that is. Do you find that to be a challenge when there are folks that don't come with a background in singing with others and knowing music? Do you find that to be a big challenge when they come to you and want you to turn this idea into a reality?
Exactly. So, you know, just over the years, I've been able to grasp every aspect of, you know, from, you know, recording, tracking vocals, and, you know, harmonies. I mean, there's just so much that goes into a record. I mean, like, there's one song I did. I did a record with L. DeBarge Jr.
Mm-hmm.
And I worked that record, I mean, I worked on that record 25 hours.
Wow. Okay.
You know, to get it to where it is, you know what I mean? We just really put a lot of production time, a lot of thought. It's just a big process of just editing, going through each track by track by track, you know, breaking it down, putting this in, maybe take that out. You know what I mean? It was just a lot of work.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of work, yeah.
Now, I know that aside from just helping singers get out there, and there's some rappers too, I know you've been responsible for some jingles. So tell us one of the major placements that you've had.
Well, I'd say the most major placement I've had with jingles is probably going to be McDonald's and Proline hair products, you know. So that was definitely a big plug under my belt when I did those.
Gotcha. I also know that you've been responsible for some music on some of our most popular TV shows, too. Go ahead.
I did some music on a television show called Lincoln Heights that airs on ABC Family.
Mm-hmm.
Also another television show called Crash that comes on Stars. Did music on a show called Love Game on the Oxygen Channel.
Mm-hmm.
And I've also done some local stuff too, you know, that some up and coming. I'm working with Zalika Thomas on a show called Esquire Men.
Okay.
That came out pretty good. And I also was the music supervisor for a television show called Inside DFW with Juan Branch on the ION network. I did that for like a year.
Okay.
There, you know, and I also had a song on Adam Sandler's feature film Benchwarmers as well.
Yeah, I was just about to get to that one. That was great. That was
yeah.
Now, with all that you've been doing out, and I wanted to shout out TV One, because they still play Lincoln Heights. So that's a major place for me. Well, TV One is one of those stations that we've been able to connect with in a different kind of way, primarily because it is a Black-owned station. And on the radio side, one of my partners got his start there. And our connection in Japan grew up with Kathy Hughes. So it's like you've got this real connection. It's always plug TV One. And I love it that you're able to do Lincoln Heights. And Lincoln Heights has been one of those shows that has had that multicultural flavor and been able to be successful. So I'm glad that you've been able to touch so many different companies and genres too. Now, you spend most of your time in where? In the U.S. or outside?
Yeah, I'm mostly in the U.S. now, but looking to soon I'll be doing some more world travels, mostly going over to Europe. I'm working with a guy by the name of Ben Newton. He's a PR person for me, and we're connected and doing some charity events and some other things. Just going to travel me over there. And also I'm working with Andrea Moscolo of Tony and Guy, and we have some business ventures going as well, and we're planning a tour to do some traveling maybe over to England.
Okay. Now, you actually have been in the industry quite a long time, more than some of the younger folks that are out there who are just putting their hands into the business. Where would you say a person should start out? If they're just like, I'm making beats at home, how do I get started? Who do I talk to? Where would you say should be, what would you say is their first step?
Well, I'd say the first step is love what you do, and the rest will take care of itself. You just really, like, if you love something and then you're passionate about it, you just do it, whether you're getting paid or not. You just do it and do it and do it. And when you do that, it'll come to you. The people will come find you. Like, if you're just working, you focus on your craft, and you're just putting in work, somebody's going to notice and like, hey, who is this guy? Yeah, that's really how it happens. They'll come find you, pretty
exactly.
much. You just got to just work hard,
How did you get connected to Three Fifths? I noticed a tribute to President Obama. How did you get connected with that? Was that something that people just found you, or were you connected with a group of folks that said, hey, this is the guy to go for?
For that film, Three Fifths?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, that was a guy by the name of Eric Williams. My reputation is just out there as doing great work, and so people just come seek me out when there's a project. They're needing music or needing somebody to do a score or something like that. My name just kind of pops up, and I get a call, and I come to the table and end up doing the deal.
Mm-hmm. That's great. Now you got your start in where you're originally from. Where? That's where I should be asking.
Say it again.
You're originally from where?
Originally from Cape Cod, Massachusetts. I was there as a young age, and then from there we moved out here to Fort Worth, Dallas. So been here for a long time.
Okay, that's where I was really leading it there. Did you find it difficult to do what you do from Texas as opposed to Atlanta or LA and New York?
I'm actually doing well in Texas because I believe I work hard and I'm to bring across a great product, and I have a very healthy and great work ethic to try to get the best out of everything that I do. And so a lot of people would say, I should move to Atlanta, New York, LA, and what I'm doing will probably blow much bigger, much faster.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, I would also be like kind of a little fish in a big pond where maybe there'd be a lot of guys that can do things like me. But here I'm kind of like a big fish in a small pond. There's hardly nobody that does what I do at that capacity here.
Gotcha.
And at the same time, I just believe that you really – wherever you are, you have to be able to have the same intensity and the same hustle. I believe that anywhere I go, I'm going to be successful because that's just the type of drive that I have.
That's right. I love it that you said that, because there's some folks that are figuring, if I just change my address, I'll do better. And we had one artist who's from San Antonio who kept writing into our Facebook group, so much, should he leave, should he move this place, should he move that place? He's trying to pick a place on the map. And I'm telling him, just stay where you are. Promote where you are, promote your music, and get you a sound following. And really just do what you got to do, because you will grow.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm glad that you brought that up. Now, we're going to go into a couple of your songs throughout the interview. But I wanted to make sure that if there's anybody out there who wants to call in, you can call in at 347-426-3974. We are on with Sazza Nation, and he is one of the hottest producers right here right here on the show. So stay tuned. We will be back with you in a few moments.
Thank you. lifetime. The Victor Clark Collection. You will feel empowered wearing the Victor Clark Collection. The best things in life comes in the Victor Clark Collection. Order online today. www.victorclarkstore.com. The Victor Clark Collection, the number one clothing brand in the country, the number one clothing brand in the world. Everybody loves Victor Clark.
We are back here on Q-Media Nation, here on Blog Talk Radio, your source for independent thought, politics, money, music, and life. I'm Sister Solana, a.k.a. Miss Q, and we have been joined by Sasa Nation, who is out there just making sure that the industry is covered with good music, not just any old music, but good music. So shout out to him for being back on with us. We have a few more minutes left to his interview. However, if you want to call in, you can do so at 347-426-3974 or text us at 201-376-7063. We're back with Sasa Nation, and thank you so much again for being with us. And I wanted to go back to something that you were talking about being from Cape Cod and then going to where you are right now in Texas. And the lay of the land, basically, is that a lot of the music comes from the South. Do you find that a lot of our Southern artists, their grind is, I guess, just a little bit more than artists from the North?
What I said is their grind here is heavier?
Yes.
No, that I really wouldn't know. I mean, as far as the grind for me. Here or there, that would be a question that I wouldn't be able to answer because, you know, how the East, because I'm since I'm mostly here, you know, I haven't really seen how the East grinds compared to.
Mm-hmm.
And I see everybody's music getting out there from each, you know, everybody has their time to shine from their region, but yeah, so that would be a hard question for me now.
Gotcha. We've had artists. Now, I'm basically in the New York, New Jersey area, and it's a different thing. When I go south, it just seems like it's a tighter knit community that comes out to support one another more so than here. It's almost like you have to drop $1,000 here, $3,000 or $4,000 here just to get an independent artist who may have sold only 100,000 copies of an album to even get on with you. Now, I just find it just a little bit difficult up this way. But now, out of all of the groups and people that you've worked with, who's been your favorite?
Out of all the people I've worked with, artist-wise?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Well, I mean, I have lots of favorites. I really enjoy working with, you know, pretty much everybody. But one of the most impressive sessions was with Raheem Devon.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, he was pretty amazing. You know, we were just sitting in the studio and just going through music, and he heard a track that he liked, and he was like, put the track on and give me the mic, and, you know, and he just walked in there, and he cut that whole thing, made it up, no writing down, nothing, I mean, just created a very, very nice piece off the top of the dome. I mean, we recorded 7 hours straight. It was crazy. Yeah, so that's probably one of
I actually, when we started in Japan, we were going from club to club, and he was with a group called Urban Ave 31 before he became the solo artist now. And they showed us the most love out of any of the groups that we had been trying to promote that weren't as well known in Japan at the time. I really love him as an artist, and I love his voice, the music, but his humility has always been something that has attracted me to his music and as well as to him as a person.
Definitely. Real, real cool guy. I mean, very, very, very. He's he should get more just due to what he's getting because he is truly an amazing artist, absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
And he was so demanding in the studio, like, you know, do this and do that and pan it over there and then copy that, put that right there and do this. I mean, it's like, and I was just I was riding with him all the way, and then when his manager, well, after we got through cutting the record, his manager was like, "Hey, dude, you good?" Because Raheem can be so demanding in the studio that most, a lot of engineers, they just quit. They give up. They can't even hang. So, like,
yeah,
hats off
right.
to you, bro.
Right.
Man, appreciate it.
And you, now, you were talking about just different genres. How, you mainly do R&B, hip-hop?
Well, when people ask me that question, my answer to that is that I just do music.
Gotcha.
I do everything that come, any and everything can come my way. Even if I've never done it before, I'll just, all I gotta do is listen to it, and grab the essence of it, you know, because I just have an ear for music, and I can pretty much find anything on the keys, and I just have a ear for it. So, I mean, when it comes to pop, rock, reggae, you know, R&B, hip hop, reggaeton, it really doesn't matter. I mean, I can touch it all. In some form or fashion, yeah.
Now, we just heard a song, Fairy Tale. Now, is that an artist that's in that particular area, or do some artists send you, they'll do some work wherever they are in the country, and then send it to you, you'll put it, arrange it, master it, send it back, give them, you know, you do a lot through the computer, or do they need to come to your studio?
Well, they don't need to come. Actually, the record Fairy Tale was a remix. That song was originally written by Rico Love, and the artist is Tynisha Kelly, and she was signed with Warner Brothers at the time that we did that record. And one of my good friends and business partners, DJ Big Bink, you know, sent those a cappella to me, and I just took it and totally rearranged the whole song, you know, created a whole other music production, took the vocals and flipped them all kind of ways, backwards and forwards, and chopped it all up, and then came up with a whole other record with it. And when they got it back, they were absolutely amazed with it. So,
but it
could be done. I could either do it. It doesn't really matter. I mean, I could do it here, or they could send me the vocals or whatever. And a lot of times I've had celebrities in the studio, and like they'd be just kind of running through, you know, real quick, you know, and they don't have time. They may come in and lay just a verse,
gotcha.
You know, and they don't have time to make a hook. So, but I'm crafty enough with editing and sampling, while I will take words out of the verse and make a hook out of it, and then you would never know that they didn't even do the hook. You know,
That's interesting, because when I was looking through your website, and I was, you know, just going through a lot of the different folks in there, there's one particular artist whose page I was loving more than anybody else, and that was your son's page. And out of all the people, that you've worked with and all kind of stuff, do you find that it's hard to work with your own child? Like, you demand more from him than you do an artist that's just walking in?
Well, no, actually, it was absolutely the opposite.
Really?
You know,
okay.
Yeah, because my son, you know, was always, you know, he got the gift in him, and I've seen it since he was 2 years old. I mean, he was always sitting in the studio watching me do everything, and at one point when he was like four, he was running the studio already, because I already tracked vocals, everything, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And then he came to me to want to make a song, and he cut his first record when he was 5 years old.
Wow,
I was like, whoa, I didn't even know he could even do all that stuff. I guess he's just been watching and absorbing. But I kind of was putting it, you know, not really putting him on the back burner, really, to a certain level. I wasn't really pushing behind it, trying to help everybody else. And finally just got tired of all the betrayal that comes along with a producer helping a lot of people. I just went ahead and decided to start working with my son. And then as we started that, the other kids came along, you know, like Diamond and Daraja and Zach. And we just kind of, it kind of evolved and evolved and evolved. And once I started working with the kids, and then that's when I saw the games completely change, and that how easy it was when we were working with kids and doing positive music. Every time we did a show, it would lead to the next show, it would lead to the next. Before you know it, we did over 200 shows.
Wow, okay. So he's really a big artist in that particular area.
Huh? He's really a big artist in that particular area, or does he travel outside of the region?
We just made do some traveling, but right now, you know, we really got a great buzz here. And through, like I said, once again, through my business partner, DJ Big Bink, I was able to connect them with Mindless Behavior and Diggie Simmons.
Okay, that's right. I did get wind of it.
And that whole situation just came out really good. I mean, it was we're on our third year, and it was just kind of like a match made in heaven with the kids, and all the parents were just wonderful on helping out. You know, Felicia, Rhonda, Kanisha, and Diane, they all really pitched in and made the whole Baby Fast crew thing stay to where it's at right now. And so now we're ready to take things to the next level, start, you know, doing some going to some other cities and, you know, doing some traveling. And I'm also getting ready to do a movie with them, of the first feature film with the Baby Fast crew. And talk about the issue of bullying in America.
That's good. I'm sure it's going to be a big hit on the junior high and high school circuit as well. And we appreciate you even telling us that there is a movie that is being done at the moment. Do you find that the younger the artist is, the better it is for him or her to be in the industry and be molded by someone like you who can really help them?
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. Because, I mean, I started with them at very young ages, like 9 and 10, and they've already done more than a lot of older artists already. Mm-hmm. I mean, their album has already been pressed up, shrink wrap, manufactured. They sold records. Mm-hmm. They've done 200 shows. They hooked up with celebrities. Already, now up to 11 and 12 years old, and they've already done that much stuff already.
Now,
like me helping them.
Mm-hmm. Now, for the younger population, who do you see them getting into Disney television and doing some other things and breaking off as a group into their own genre?
You mean like will the crew like kind of like go do their own things later?
Right. Trying to break up and not so much just break up, but get this as their start.
Absolutely. I think that, I think it's just the whole thing evolved into what it is. And eventually, you know, they're all very, very, very talented in their own right. And so as it moves, they'll all break off and they'll do different things. But they're going to always be a core unit, because they came up together kind of like, Britney Spears and Justin Timberlake on the Mickey Mouse Club, came up together, and then they'll branch off and do different things later on, but this is definitely the stepping stone to build them, and getting them prepped and ready, for Hollywood and the music business and wherever they want to go in life,
Now, as we're winding now, we're coming down to me. I'm going to say this is the last question before you want to give any comments, but do you have any advice for parents who are trying to get their child into the industry?
To try to get their child in the industry?
Exactly.
The main thing is to just kind of try to look at your child as, you have to be able to separate your child from your artist, and not be too personal because, and I've seen a lot of times, some momagers are just kind of like, it's hard for people to want to touch that because it can be a little too dramatic and the child can end up losing because the mama or daddy is just way, way, way over the top, So you just got to be cool and lean back and be able to listen and absorb things, More than that, you have to be able to listen. You can never learn it all. You can never know it all. You got to listen. But I just want to also just give a, shout out to some of my business partners that I'm working with that's been really helping me out a lot. Of course, Shane over at the Boot Camp and Andrea Muscolo, Ben Wiseman over at Parliament Records, and Christian Smalls and one of my other business partners, Matthew Iafrate, Tina Trixler, Lewis, L.C. Connor, and Malcolm Snell, some of the people I'm that's doing really good business with, and I've got a lot of great singers and stuff I'm working with, you know, Jay Sabin, Prez, Jay Davis, people like that, you know, Jose V. Just working with a lot of different artists, you know. Of course, you heard Tina DeVon doing some stuff with her as well, you know. And Shane told me I really like that record a lot, and you've been hearing it a lot already.
I have to tell you, originally I was like, is this an R&B cut? And then one night, late after the show, we were sitting around and I was replaying the show, and I really had an opportunity to listen to the words. And it's just a song that really touches the heart. And we had a few people that had requested that we play it again. So we added it to our playlist. And it's been history since then.
Oh, awesome. That is really awesome. And also look out, there's a couple of other people, you know, look out for a young lady by the name of Kenya. She is really a powerhouse. She can really sing. Ingrid Barra, and has a very smooth, cool style. You know, just a lot of people I'm kind of just, you know, watching them kind of just manifest and do their thing. So, you know, a lot of good things are coming down the pipeline for sure.
And we want to thank you so much for taking the time out to be with us. We totally enjoy you being here, and any of your artists that are really wanting to get out there and get some airplay, things like that, we are definitely in the market for giving good music to good people who support us, we support them, and giving it out to the world. So shout out to you, the whole, and shout out the website so that people can.
Okay, my website was designed by my brother too, Skip Knight, and he has a company called The Imaginist, and he's the one to design my website along with myself, and it is fazzanation.com, and that's spelled P-H-A-Z-Z-A-N-T-I-O-N, fazzanation.com. Y'all can go in there and check me out, and you can also shoot me an email from that address as well.
Yeah. We didn't get a chance to talk about some of your other companies that you're working with.
One of my other companies I'm working with is a clothing franchise called the Victor Clark Collection. And, you know, I'm also, you know, into shooting videos and editing, so I've probably done over 100 commercials for that as well. And, you know, people I'm working with on that project is like Wendy Schofield and Kevin Dozier and Matt Off right there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And that's doing pretty well. And, you know, even on the television show earlier, I was telling you about Inside DFW on the ION Network, you know, through that whole situation, I was able to run commercials on television for like a whole year. Once a week, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, we played a commercial every night here, so...
I really appreciate it. And also, too, you know, on the other side, you know, I'm a guy who likes to show love to people who show love to me, so I'm just going to let it be known right here on air that anything that I can do to help you, you know, you're having me on your show and letting me talk about the things that I do and help promote me. So if there's something that you would need my help on, I would be more than happy. It would be my pleasure to do it for you.
And we love it that you had the time to stop in and check in with us. And we look forward to bringing more of the artists that you have out there on, and folks that are out there that are just making strides in the industry. We always want to make sure this show is a resource, and not just entertainment, but the business of entertainment. Mm-hmm. All right?
Thank you so much. All right, no, and last but not least, I definitely want to shout out one of my other companies real quick is Typhoon Productions. Well, I'm working with a guy named Taiwo Apollo Wo. Goes by T-Boy. He's an awesome songwriter. And, you know, we definitely got a lot of things coming down the pipeline. So look out for Typhoon Production. That's really going to be a crazy, crazy hot venture when it comes out.
Okay. All right. You all heard it first here. Fascination here on Q Media Nation Radio. We're going to go into a couple of his songs, and then we'll be out for the night, but we will not be out forever. We will be back with you Monday night. You won't want to miss what we have in store for you for next week. You will see us on Facebook. You can catch us at Kumar Muhammad, Q-U-M-A-I, Muhammad, M-U-H-A-M-M-A-D, or on Indie Talk Japan. We will be releasing next week's program. You will hear this music and much, 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 much more because we are the livest in urban online radio, serving our listeners around the world. We thank you for being with us for another week and being successful. Enjoy your weekend. If you're up in the Northeast, you know we're supposed to get some snow. So stay in, enjoy. Reconnect to the show. Send us an email. Let us know how you're doing in the area where you are. QMediaGroupUSA@gmail.com. Thank you. We love you. And good night.
We'll be tipping in the parking lot. Na 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 na, going hard, we keep it hot. Na 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 na, and you know it don't stop. Na 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 na, pivot, but pivot, but pivot, pivot in the parking lot. Pivot in the parking lot. Na na na,
we checking in, baby. Big fan, hold on, homie.
And you know it don't stop.
Stop the line, I'm taking over.
Pivot, but pivot, but pivot, pivot in the parking lot.
Otro chico.
que lo hace como mi mami. Baby girl, come on and talk to me. I'm searching for the wifey type. Hey, you ever traveled overseas and had the candlelight? Dinner with the love songs and everything that night was right. Shine you up with flawless ice that light it up extra bright. Keep in mind you with a G, but baby girl, tonight your night. These trees will ride with me and take a step off in my life. XO got me feeling right, now I'm looking to see you. Let throw that say, show you what them whipped cream and cherries do. Never set a limit, shawty, when it come to pleasing you. Eat you like a sundae, Mr. Ice Cream Man, boo. So loguito con el lengua, baby girl, I thought you knew. Looking for a freaky chick, but shawty must be classy too. Let's take a trip to ecstasy, I'll show you something you ain't new.